स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज क्लास सिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर टू, एस्टिमेशन. नाउ फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद व्हाट इज एस्टिमेशन. एस्टिमेशन मीन्स टू मेक एन आइडिया अबाउट क्वांटिटीज, टू जज और टू अप्रोक्सीमेट साइज, कॉस्ट, पॉपुलेशन. एंड इट इज ऑल्सो फाइंडिंग अ नंबर दैट इज क्लोज इनफ टू द राइट आंसर. In estimation, we are not supposed to find the exact answer, but to find a close enough answer, approximate answer. So why we need estimation? It can save our time. It can save money. It can save you from making mistakes with calculations. Estimation is also known as rounding off numbers to nearest 10, nearest 100, or to nearest 1000. One of the example given in your book, you can see that to organize a sports event or to approximate the estimate of expenditure is required or imagined. For example, suppose expenditure on invitation card is ₹1530 and expenditure on hiring the furniture is ₹7250 and expenditure on dresses for participants is 11,638. Then the expenditure on transportation is 4,547, and the expenditure on refreshment is 2,590, and miscellaneous other expenses is 6,240. So when they add it up, the total or the approximate or the total estimate is equal to 33,795. So this gives a round figure. This gives a not, this expenses may be, you know, it can be exact figure or may not be, but this gives you an idea how much amount to be spent on an event. Now we will see the rounding of a number to the nearest 10. The steps are: see the digit at the unit's place, very much important, the unit's place or one's place. Then if the digit at one's place is less than 5, then you have to replace the one's place digit by 0 and you have to keep the other digit as they are. And third step is, if the digit of one place is 5 or more than 5, then you have to increase the tens place digit by 1 and replace the one's place digit by 0. For example, 542. If you see the ones place digit, it is 2, which is less than 5. Rule number 2, less than 5. So you have to replace this ones place digit by 0, and they all other digits will remain as it is, 5, 4, 0. So 542 is rounded off to 540 to nearest tens. Now this is another example, 347. So if you see this ones place digit, this is more than 5, rule number 3. You have to increase the tens place digit by 1, means you have to increase this 4 by 1, means it becomes 5. And you have to replace the ones place digit by 0. So 347 is rounded off to 350. Next is rounding off to nearest 100. So you see the steps. Now here, 100, nearest 100, for rounding off we have to see the digit at tens place. Then if the digit at tens place is less than 5, you have to replace each one of tens and ones digit by 0, and you have to keep the other digit as they are. For example, this 549. So here you can see this tens place digit is 4, 4 is less than 5. So you have to replace each one of tens and ones digit by 0, means you have to replace this tens place and ones place by 0, and other digit will remain as it is, 5 is remaining as it is. So when you round off to nearest 100, this 549 will become 500. Now next, third step, if the digit at tens place is 5 or more than 5, then increase the hundreds digit by 1 and replace ones and tens digit by 0. So if you consider this example 564 and take this tens place digit, what you will see, this is more than 5. So we have to replace this tens place and this ones place by 0, and we have to increase this hundred place by 1. Now let us take another example, 852. Here again you see 5. So 5 is there, so we have to replace this ones place or tens place by 0, and we have to increase this hundred place by 1. So it becomes 900 after rounding it off. Next is rounding of a number to nearest 1000. Remember, for 1000 we have to see the hundreds place digit. So if the hundreds place digit is less than 5, replace each one of the hundreds, tens and ones digit by 0, and the other digits will remain as it is. And if the hundred digit is 5 or more than 5, increase the 1000 digit by 1 and replace each other digit by on its right by 0. So now take the example 2349. We will take up for rounding off to nearest 1000, we will take the hundreds digit. This is 1s, 10s, 100. Hundreds place digit, that is 3. It is less than 5. Less than 5 means you have to replace 100, 10s, 1s place digit by zeros, and other remain digits will remain as it is. So this will round off to 2000. Now take another example, 5432. And this is 4, 100 place digit. So you see, this is less than 5. So all the 100 place, 1's place, 10's place digit will replace by 0, and other digit will remain as it is. So this is 5432 will round off to 5000. Now let's take up one other example, 5629. Again we will consider this 100 place digit. So you see, it is more than 5. 5 or more than 5. So more than 5, you have to increase this 1000 place by 1, and other will remain, you will replace by 0. So this is increased by 1 and other you will replace by zeros. Now 7000, let's take up another example, 7536. Here it is, 100 place digit is 5. Again it is 5. Rule number 3, always remember, rule number 3, it is 5 or more than 5. You have to increase the 1000 place digit by 1. So this is 7, in increasing it will get 8. And you have to replace 100, 10s, 1s place digit by zeros. So 7536 will round off to 8000. Now let's take up some exercise question. Exercise 2A, round off each of the following to the nearest tens. So I have taken some of the numbers. First number is 62. 62 nearest tens, I have told you, you have to see the ones place digit. So 62, the ones place digit is 2, it is less than 5. So this ones place digit will be replaced by 0 and other remain digits will remain as it is. So 62 is rounded off to 60. Then next number is 265. Again you see this ones place digit is 5. So this tens place will increase by 1, it will become 7, and other will replace by 0. Ones place digit will be replaced by 0. So it is 2070. Now again you see, this is 8261. 61, ones place digit 1 is less than 5, so it has been replaced by 0 and other digits will remain as it. Now 3008, so this 8 is more than 5. So more than 5 means tens place digit will increase by 1, so it has been increased by 1 and ones place digit will be replaced by 0, other digits will remain as it is. So 3010. And this is 326. So this is 6. Again it is more than 5. So what you will do, you will increase this tens place by 1, So it becomes 72,330. Now, question number 2 of your book is round off each of the following to nearest 100. So you see, round off to nearest 100. First number is 748. Nearest 100, I have told you children, for nearest 100 we have to see tens place digit. So this is tens place digit. It is less than 5. So obviously tens and ones place will be replaced by zeros and other digit will remain as it is. So force 748 will become 700. This is 2667. So you see, if you take tens place digit, it is more than 5. So it will increase, the 100 place digit will be increased by 1. So it becomes 7 and other digits, tens place and 100 place digit will be replaced by 0. So it becomes 2700. And next you see this example, 59,237. So this is your 3 which is in tens place. It is less than 5. So what will happen? There will be no change in the 100 place digit. 2 will remain as it is and tens place and ones place digit will be replaced by 0. Next is question number 3, round off each of the following to the nearest 1000. Now if you take to nearest 1000, what I have told you in the rules, for nearest 1000 you have to check the 100 place digit. So this is 6475. This is 1000 place, that is 4. 4 is less than 5. So less than 5 means there will be no change and each of 100, 10s and 1's place digit will be replaced by 0. The next is 25,352. Again we will take this 100 place digit, that is 3, which is again less than 5. So there will be no change in the 1000 place digit. It will remain as it is and 100 place, 10's place, 1's place digit will be replaced by 0. Next is 83,294. So as you see, this is again 2. It is less than 5. So it will be 83,000. Next is question number 4, round off. They have given you some numbers. For example, 578 to nearest 10s. So you have to see for nearest tens the ones place digit, that is your 8. 8 is more than 5, so ones tens place digit will be increased by 1, that is 580. Likewise, you have to do this question as per the instruction given in your copy as homework. And the remaining parts also, what I have not done in the video, all the parts actually, you have to do it in your copy. Next is round off, question number 5, round off each of the following to nearest 10, nearest 100 and nearest 1000, and they have given you some 7 numbers. For this, what you have to do, you have to make a table like this. You write the number here, the nearest 10, nearest 100 and nearest 1000. Then write the first number, 864, for example, I have taken. So nearest 10, we have to see this ones place. So it is less than 5, it will become 860. Now for nearest 100, we have to see the tens place digit, that is 6, which is more than 5. So this 100 place digit will increase by 1, that is your 900. And for nearest 1000, you have to see the 100 place digit, that is your 8. 8 is again more than 5, so it will increase. So it become 1000. Now next is your this 56,293. So it will become 56,290 since ones place digit is 0. Now next is this one. This is your nearest 100, you have to see the 10th place digit, 9. So obviously the 100th place digit will increase by 1. Here it is 2, it becomes 3. 56,300. Then next is your, you have to see the 100th place digit for nearest 1000. It is 2. 2 is less than 5, so there will be no change. Simply you will replace the other digits by 0. Likewise, we have done other sums. Now come to next question, question number 6. Round off each of the following to the nearest tens. So this is given rupees 562. So 5 for 562, you have to convert this into nearest 10, 562. So 2, you have to see for nearest 10, you have to see the 1's place digit, 2 is less than 5. Less than 5 will become 560. Very important here, unit is given, you have to mention the unit. Otherwise, there will be marks deduction. So remember to write the units. Now here 545 centimeter. It will round off to 550 centimeter. Very important to write the units. The next question is, list all the numbers which can be round off to nearest 30. So what numbers you can round off to 30? That is 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34. Till here you can round off all these numbers to 30. And when it becomes 35, you see, when it becomes 35, what will happen? This is 5, which is, when you round off, it will become nearest to 40. So it cannot be rounded off to 30. So we have not included those numbers. Next, question number 8, round off to 50. List all the numbers. You have to list all the numbers which can be rounded off to 50. So for that, you have to do same as question number 7. This is an homework for you again. Then write the smallest and the largest number which can be round off to 90. So these are the numbers which can be round off to 90, 85 to 94. The smallest one is 85 and the largest number is 94. Now question number 10 of your book is, write the smallest and the largest number which can be round off to 130. So again, this is an homework for you. It is same as question number 9. So you have to do all these questions in your copy. If you have any doubt, we will discuss it later on. Students, now we will start with chapter number 2, estimation exercise 2B. First question is to estimate the sum of each pair of numbers to nearest 10. So let's take up first bit, 67 and 44. So 67 to nearest 10 will be, this is 7 in 1's place, so it is more than 5. So 10's place digit will be increased by 1, that is 7, and 1's place digit will be replaced by 0. And same way, 44 to nearest 10 will become 40, since 1's place digit is 4, which is less than 5. So estimated sum will be equal to 70 plus 40, that is 110. This is your answer. Now let's take up another example. Let's take 7th one, 457 and 175. So here 457, we have to round off to nearest 10. So this is 7 more than 5. So 10's place digit will be increased by 1, it will become 460. And this is 175, this is 5, so it will be rounded off to 180. So again, estimated sum will be equal to 460 plus 180.
that is equal to 640. So rest of the parts you can try it on your own. Now let's see question number 2. Estimate the sum of each pair of numbers to nearest 100. So let's take up first one, that is 336 and 782. So question number 2, it is 336 and 782. We have to first round off to the nearest 100. So 336. For rounding off to nearest 100, what we have to do? We have to see the tens place digit. It is less than 5. So it will be rounded off to 300. Now 782. We have to again see the tens place digit. So you can see it is more than 5. So 100 place digit will be increased by 1, that is 8. Another will be replaced by zeros. So your estimated sum will be equal to 300 plus 800, that is 1100. So this will be your answer. Now let's take up another part, that is fourth part of same question number 2. 4,280 and 5,295. So you see 4,280, when you round off to nearest 100, you have to see the tens place digit. So it is more than 5. So more than 5 means 100 place digit will be increased by 1. So it will become 4,300. And this is 5,295. So again, this is more than 5. And this will become 5,300. So estimated sum will be now equal to 4,300 plus 5,300, which is equal to your 9,600. Now let's see question number 3, that is to estimate the sum of the following pairs to nearest 1,000. So let's take first part, 53826, that is 53,826 and 36,455. So when you round off to nearest 1,000, so what do we have to do? We have to see the hundreds place digit. So this is 8, which is more than 5. So more than 5 means this 1,000 place digit will increase by 1. So this will become 54123, 3 zeros. 1, 2, 3, so 3 zeros. Then this is 36455. So if you take this and you have to round off to nearest 1,000, you have to take 100 place digit. So it is less than 5. So there will be no change. So 36000. Now you have to find the estimated sum. So this will be the addition of this and this. So you will be getting 90,000. So this is how you have to do question number 3. Now see question number 4, you have to estimate the following differences correct to nearest 10. So again, you have to here in this question, you have to find the difference between the two numbers. So question number 4, this is 82 minus 27. You have to round off to nearest 10. So when you round off to nearest 10, 82 will become, this is 2, which is less than 5, it will become 80. And it is 7, it is more than 5, so it will become 30. So the difference is your 50. This is your required difference. This is your required estimated difference. Now see question number 5. Estimate each difference to nearest 100. So nearest 100, let's take up one more thing. 769 minus 314. So you have to round off to nearest 100. So we have to see the tens place digit here also, here also. So this is more than 5. So this place, 100 place digit will be increased by 1. This will become 800. And this is less than 5. So there will be no change in the 100 place digit and other digit will be replaced by 0. So this will become 100, 800 and this will become 300. So the difference which you need, required difference, will be equal to 500. So this is your estimated required difference. Now same here, question number 6. Estimate each difference to nearest 1000. So nearest 1000, what we have to do? This is 45974. This is 45,974 minus 38,766. For rounding off to nearest 1000, we have to see the nearest, that is your 100th place digit. So this will become, this is more than 5, this will become 4600, 46,000. And this will become, this is again more than 5, so this place will increase by 1. It will become 39,000. So when you subtract it, how much you will getting? You will be getting 7,000. This is your required difference. Now see question number 7. Estimate each of the following products by rounding off each number to nearest 10. You have to find the product by rounding off to each to nearest 10. Again, this is very easy. Question number 7. 49 multiplied by 52 and we have to round off to nearest 10. So we have to see the ones place digit. So this will become 50 because 9 is more than 5. So there will be increase in the tens place digit, they become 50 and this will become also become 50 because it is less than 2. So there will be no change, less than 5, 2, that is 2 is given here in the ones place digit and which is less than 5, so it will become 50. So 50 into 50, 5 5s are 25 and 1, 2, 2 zeros. So this is your required product. So this is how you have to do all the rest of the questions. Now come to question number 8. Question number 8 is estimate the following product by rounding off each the number to nearest 100. Nearest 100 we have to round off. So let's take up one more example. 477 multiplied by 213. So we have to round off to nearest 100. So here we have to take up tens place digit. Here it is more than 5, so there will be increase in the 100 place digit, it will become 500 multiplied by, and this is less than 5, so there will be no change. So again, if you see 5 2s are 10, this 5 into 2 is 10. How many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. So this is your 100,000. This is your required product. So this is how you have to solve other questions also. Now come to question number 9. Here, estimate each of the following by rounding of first number to nearest 10. Very particular over here, you have to first number, you have to round off to nearest 10. Then the other number you have to round off to nearest 100. So let's take up one more example. This is 28 multiplied by 287. Question number 9. So first number we have to round off to nearest 10. Sorry, 10. So here if you see, we have to see the ones place digit. So it is more than 5, so it will become 30. And this is 287. We have to round off to nearest 100. So for 100 we have to see the tens place digit. It is again more than 5. So there will be increase in a number over here. So it will become 300. So your estimated product will be equal to 30 into 300. That is 3 3s are 9. And how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3. So 9000 is your answer. Now next question, that is, you estimate the following, each of the following question by converting each number to the nearest 10. You have to solve each of them. You have to find the quotient in each of the following by converting each number to nearest 10. So let's take up one example. So question number 10. First part, let's take 87 divided by 28. So we have to round off to nearest 10. So here you see this is 7 ones place digit. You have to see while rounding off to nearest 100, you have to see the ones place digit. So here it is 7 more than 5, so there will be subsequent increase in the tens place. So this will become 90 divided by, this is again more than 5, so there will be increase in the tens place digit, that has become 30. So your required quotient will be equal to 90 divided by 30. It is 00 got cancelled, 3 ones are 3 and 3 threes are 9. Your answer is 3. 3 is your required quotient. Now let's take up one more example. Okay, let's take up 6th part. 444 divided by 42. 444 divided by 42. Again, we have to round off to nearest tens, so we have to see the ones place digit. This will become 440 since it is less than 5, divided by, and this is again less than 5, it will become 40. So your required quotient will be equal to 440 divided by 40. So 00 got cancelled, 4 ones are 4, 4 elevens are 44. So your required answer is 11. So children, this is how you have to solve the whole exercise, and you have to try out each and every part of the sum.